Good morning, dear students. Now today I will take a poem, An Elementary School Classroom in a Slum, written by Stephen Spender. So first of all, you'll have to know about the writer and about the poem. Stephen Spender was an English poet and an essayist. He left University College, Oxford, without taking a degree and went to Berlin in 1930. Spender took a keen interest in politics and declared himself to be a socialist and pacifist. Books by Spender include Poems of Dedication, The Age of Being, The Creative Element, The Struggle of the Modern, and an autobiography, World Within World. In an elementary school classroom in a slum, he has concentrated on themes of social injustice and class inequalities. Actually, the children of an elementary slum school, means basic slum school, look pathetic and miserable. They have pale faces. Their disorderly hairs look like rootless weeds. They are stunted figures with twisted bones, inheriting diseases of their parents. They belong to the dirty world of cramped holes. The map of the world on the wall symbolizes the world of the powerful, rich, or you can say aristocrat, and important people. The gap between the two worlds can be abridged if these children are removed from their dirty surroundings and made to enjoy fresh air and have physical as well as mental development. Now here you see a very beautiful poem or a very good pen picture by Stephen Spender. So now we'll start stanza wise the poem explanation. An elementary school classroom in a slum. Now dear students, see the picture, means how they sit in the classroom together and how they look like. Far, far from gusty waves, these children's faces, like rootless weeds, the hair torn around their pallor, the tall girl with her weighed down head. Actually, when I taught this poem in your school, when the school has just started. So here this is just a revision also. Those who have the students, those who have taken the periods of mine, or those who have attended my lecture in those days. So here just the revision for them, and for the request of some children that they want that this poem again being explained. So now look here. That far, far from gusty waves, these children's faces, like rootless weeds, the hair torn around their pallor. First of all, gusty means blowing strongly, जो तेज झोंके जो आते हैं हवा के. Rootless means uprooted. Weeds, here weeds means useless wild plants, means खरपतवार. Torn around, scattered around, in disorder, जो अव्यवस्थित रूप से बिखरे हुए हैं. पैलर मीन्स पेल फेसेस, बहुत ही जीर्ण हीन चेहरे, विवर्ण चेहरे जिसको हम कहते हैं. वेट डाउन, वेट डाउन मीन्स डिप्रेस्ड ड्यू टू द बर्डन, और यू कैन से सैड मेलंकली फीलिंग्स दे हैव. सो नाउ आई स्टार्ट टू एक्सप्लेन दिस. The children of an elementary school classroom in a slum look pathetic and miserable. They have pale and lifeless faces. Their disorderly hair are torn around and look like rootless weeds. They are depressed. Yes, these children are depressed and keep their heads down. They have stunted growth. They inherit the diseases of their parents. They do have dreams. They have dreams. A sweet young boy is sitting unnoted at the back of his dim classroom. Is here you see that far, far from gusty waves or far from these strong waves, these children's faces look like a lifeless face or pale face and just like rootless weeds. Here simile is used. Simile, figure of speech is used in life. The hair turn around their pallor means their disorderly hair are torn around and look like rootless weeds. They are scattered. These hair scattered over their face, pale face. The tall girl also you'll have to see there in the class who has weighed down hair. Weighed down hair means that depressed face he has due to the burden which she got from the ancestors. At back of the dim class, one unnoted, sweet and young, his eyes live in a dream. Means here you see that they have stunted growth, they inherit the diseases of the parents, they are depressed also, that's why their heads weighed down. It doesn't mean that they don't have the dreams, they have dreams. So here you also see a sweet young boy sitting unnoted at the back of his gym classroom. Here you also see that one boy who has seated and not be noted by the others. His eyes live in a dream means he has looked like that, he has some dreams also in his eyes. And of a squirrel's game in the tree room. Other than this means the boy, the young boy who has seated in this dim classroom, who has the dreams also, he is dreaming of a squirrel's game in trees and of other interesting places other than this dull and drab classroom. Means he is not a keen desire to attend the class, but he has his own dreams, and that's why he has seen outside, and outside he saw the squirrel's game in trees and he felt happy while seeing all these outside scenes. On so cream walls, donations, Shakespeare's hat, cloudless at dawn, civilized Rome riding all cities. And in this classroom, you also being able to see the gifts given as donations, and the picture of Shakespeare's hat are hung on the unpleasant creamy walls. Means the walls which has not been painted, it has just looked like very dull or unpleasant, unhappy. But the gifts which has been given by someone else in donation, and the picture of Shakespeare's head, not the full picture of Shakespeare, but only the face of that Shakespeare's only head are hung on that dull cream wall. But these are useless to these unfortunate children. Do you think that is there any use of these such kind of picture of Shakespeare for these children? There is no use of these picture for them, because they have empty stomach. As you know, that sound mind is always in sound body. When they didn't get the 2-time meal, then how can they be interested to see the picture on the wall of such great poets or the writers or any great person, any great personality? So on these unpleasant cream walls, the gifts which has been given by someone else or the leaders in donation, so here the Shakespeare's head or Shakespeare's picture also being hung on the dull cream wall. But these all have useless for them, for these children. There is no use at all. Cloudless at dawn. Dawn means early morning. Civilized dome riding all cities. But these are useless to these unfortunate children. In the early morning, the sky is cloudless. Domes of the institutions of the civilized world shine in every city. Bell, flowery, tireless valley, open-handed map, awarding the world its world. And yet for these children, these windows, not this map, their world. So here you see that stunted is not here. So already known that unpleasant, and donations means you know that things given as gifts. Shakespeare's head, I told you earlier, that picture or statue of Shakespeare's head only. Dawn means early morning. Civilized dome means institutions of the civilized world. Now here we come on the point that belled flowery. Belled means hote having bells. Belled means having bells, means ghantiyon wali. Tyrolis valley, actually valley in Tyrol in Austria. It has placed in Austria. Open-handed map means map of the world drawn at will. Actually, it means that by the dictators like Hitler, जैसे हिटलर जैसे तानाशाह लोगों द्वारा बनाया हुआ अपना ही मैप, जिस खुले हाथ से जिसको दुनिया के मानचित्र को इच्छा अनुसार अपने आप बढ़ाया और घटाया जाना, मीन्स जो अच्छा नहीं लगा है उसे हटा दिया और जो अच्छा लग रहा है उसी उसी को, मतलब ऑल द गुड एस्पेक्ट्स विल हैव टू जस्ट शोन टू द अदर्स, है ना. एक्चुअल मतलब जो पोजिशन है, एक्चुअल जो है बेटा, उसको ना ही दिखाना, ऐसा जो है उसमें दिखाया गया. ओपन हैंडेड मैप मीन्स जो हमको अच्छा लग रहा है, जो तानाशाह लोगों को अच्छा लग रहा है, जो पॉलिटिशियंस लोगों को अच्छा लग रहा है, जो दोज हु बिलोंग टू द एरिस्टोक्रेट फैमिली और द ग्रेट पर्सनैलिटी, वो जो चाहते हैं वही वो उन्होंने अपना दिखा दिया है, ओपन हैंडेड मैप, है ना. जो वास्तविक चित्रण है, जो वास्तविकता है, उसको छुपा देना, और जो अनचाहा, जो जो नहीं चाहते हैं वो अनचाहा नहीं दिखाना, और जो वो चाहते हैं वो दिखा देना, मतलब इस तरह से इसको बताया गया है, ओपन हैंडेड मैप. हेयर अवॉर्डिंग मीन्स गिविंग द अवॉर्ड. इट्स वर्ल्ड द वर्ल्ड एज पार्टीशन बाय द कॉन्करर्स. These children in the slum school. And not this map means the other world of important, rich and civilized people. The world of civilized people. This is not the world of these children, those who lived the life in slum area. So now, dear student, I explained here. Now, domes of the institutions of the civilized world shine in every city. Means in the early morning, the sky is cloudless. And these domes of the institutions of the means जो गुंबद जो institutions के ऊपर आपने जो देखे होंगे ना गुंबद टाइप का जो रहता है जैसे गुरुद्वारे में भी आपने देखा होगा उस टाइप का ही डोम्स से मतलब है उनका जो डोम्स हैं institutions के बड़े बड़े डोम्स ऑफ द institutions ऑफ द civilized वर्ल्ड शाइन इन एवरी सिटी सो आर दे इन टायरोल वैली मीन्स Is there any use of showing such institutions for these children? Music of bells and fragrance of flowers pervade there. You see that the music of the bells and the fragrance of flowers scattered there. The map of this world is made and reshaped by the people in power. I mean, though the people, those who have in power, they have reshaped these maps or this world. But for these children of a school in the slum, that world is meaningless. There is no use for them. Where all their futures painted with a fog, a narrow street sealed in with a lead sky. Far, far from rivers, caps, and stars of words. As you see the pen picture given by Stephen here. But for these children of a school in the slum, that world which has been reshaped by the powerful person is meaningless for the children, those who live their life in slum area. Their own windows are dirty. Their own windows means their own world are dirty. Unpleasant surroundings form their world. Form the world of these children. The fog of uncertainty dominates their future. They are doomed to live in narrow streets closed in by the bluish gray sky. Actually, their world is far away from rivers, caps, and stars. The person, those who are in power, they have just reshaped the map according to them and placed there the Tyrol Valley of Austria. Music of bells and fragrance of flowers scattered there in the on the map, but there is no use for them. Actually, they lived a very dirty life. They lived a very unpleasant life. So these rivers, these caps, these stars are far away. They are very far beyond from their actual world. The world where they live. So dear students, here I stop my explanation and tomorrow I will take the other stanzas or the coming stanzas for explanation. Okay, thanks a lot. Goodbye.